Evaluate the indefinite integral as a power series, then determine the radius of convergence. We have big f of x equals the indefinite integral of natural log of the quantity 1 minus x divided by 2x dx. To determine the power series for the integrand function, we'll first have to determine the power series for the numerator of natural log of the quantity 1 minus x. To do this, we need to recognize the derivative of natural log of the quantity 1 minus x will resemble the known geometric power series of 1 divided by the quantity 1 minus x, which equals a sum from n equals 0 to infinity of x to the power of n. Let's begin by letting y of x equal the natural log function. Notice the derivative is equal to 1 divided by the quantity 1 minus x times the derivative of 1 minus x, which is negative 1, giving us negative 1 divided by the quantity 1 minus x, which is equal to the opposite of the sum from n equals 0 to infinity of x to the power of n, which equals a sum from n equals 0 to infinity of the opposite of x to the power of n. And here are the first several terms of the power series. So now we have the power series for y prime of x, but we want the power series for y of x. We can recover y of x by determining the indefinite integral of y prime of x. Recall, the indefinite integral of y prime of x dx equals c plus y of x. So if we find the indefinite integral of the power series of y prime of x, we can determine the power series for y of x. Integrating the power series for y prime of x, we have c plus the sum from n equals 0 to infinity of the opposite of x to the power of n plus 1, all divided by n plus 1. Notice here we added 1 to the exponent on x, and then divided by the new exponent. We can actually simplify this by starting n at 1 rather than 0. The sum from n equals 0 to infinity of the opposite of x to the power of n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 is the same as the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of the opposite of x to the power of n divided by n. Now that we have the indefinite integral for y of x, we need to recognize that in our case, for y of x, c is equal to 0, and therefore y of x, which is equal to the natural log of the quantity 1 minus x, equals the power series, the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of the opposite of x to the power of n divided by n. Now that we have the power series for y of x, we can go back and determine the power series for the original integrand function, which is natural log of the quantity 1 minus x divided by 2x, which we can write as 1 divided by 2x times the power series for natural log of the quantity 1 minus x, which is, again, the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of negative x to the power of n divided by n. And now we bring the 1 divided by 2x into the power series. Notice x to the power of n divided by x to the first equals x to the power of n minus 1, and the denominator becomes 2 times n, which equals 2n. Finally, we have the power series for the integrand function, and we can determine the indefinite integral as a power series. Big f of x equals the indefinite integral of the power series for little f of x, which indicates the original indefinite integral is equal to c plus the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of the opposite of x to the power of n minus 1 plus 1, which simplifies to n, all divided by n. Well, we already have 2n in the denominator, n times 2n equals 2n squared. This is the power series for the original indefinite integral. And now we need to determine the radius of convergence of the power series, which we'll do on the next slide. We'll apply the ratio test, so we'll determine the limit as n approaches infinity of the absolute value of a sub n plus 1 divided by a sub n, which for the series to converge must be less than 1. A sub n is the given formula. A sub n plus 1 is the opposite of x to the power of n plus 1 divided by the product of 2 and the square of n plus 1. And now we'll set up the limit, where we have the limit as n approaches infinity of the absolute value of a sub n plus 1 divided by a sub n. Let's write this quotient as a product by multiplying by the reciprocal of a sub n. And now let's begin to simplify. A negative divided by a negative simplifies to a positive. 2 divided by 2 simplifies to 1. And x to the power of n plus 1 divided by x to the power of n simplifies to 1 factor of x. The limit simplifies to the limit as n approaches infinity of x times n squared divided by the square of n plus 1. Notice as n approaches infinity, n squared is degree 2, and so is the square of n plus 1, and therefore the limit of this part equals the ratio of leading coefficients, which is 1 divided by 1 or 1, and therefore the limit equals the absolute value of x, which we know from the ratio test must be less than 1 for convergence, which indicates the radius of convergence equals 1. I also want to mention, we now know that the series converges on the open interval from negative 1 to 1. However, for the interval of convergence, we would need to test the endpoints of x equals negative 1 and x equals 1 and determine if the series converges or not at those values. I hope you found this helpful.